Nicole Wilson got breast implants 14 years ago. She thought they'd help turn her life around. Instead, they turned it upside down.
I had gone through cancer. My mom had passed away. My son had been sick. And so about a year after my cancer, I thought, hey, I want to do something to make myself feel better.
After surviving thyroid cancer, Wilson got implants and a breast lift. She felt great at first.
And then probably about 6 months into it, something just hit where I felt like I had had a stroke.
Many days she was so sick, she couldn't even get out of bed. She started having seizures and losing control of her body.
It got to the point where my muscles were just, you know, doing their own thing, throwing things in the air. I wasn't allowed to pick up anything breakable because you never knew where it would end up.
Paula was also suffering from back pain and losing weight. She didn't just feel different, though. She looked different, too. Doctors thought maybe she had a number of things, including MS. They hoped an MRI might reveal some answers.
Everything just turned up negative.
It was a frustrating time for Paula.
Cancer, for me, the treatment was easier. I was able to function with my family.
Even after countless appointments with doctors in OKC and Dallas, still no answers.
You do feel like it's in your head, like, am I causing this? Am I a hypochondriac? But the physical sense, people are seeing it, they know that there is something wrong. You just can't figure out what it is.
Along the way, Paula realized one of her implants just didn't feel right. And after 14 years of suffering, she asked a doctor to take them out. Paula remembers waking up from surgery and knowing in that moment, everything had changed. Her doctor also noticed.
He said, Paula, you're different. Your face, your hair, you just sound different. Everything about you. And so he began to listen and ask me what effects I saw, because he's seeing more women come in and ask to have them taken out.
After the removal, Paula did some research of her own, and through private Facebook groups, she found a community of women going through similar problems.
They have mold in them. They have unidentified chemicals in them. There are just so many stories that women have.
She wishes she knew she could have asked to see her implants when they were removed.
And that's something I think the medical industry does not want you to know, but you need to take responsibility and say, I want to investigate this. I want to see, you know, what's going on.
According to the American Society of Plastic Surgeons, breast augmentation was the top procedure in 2018, with more than 310,000 patients having it done.
Some local doctors, like Dr. Melinda Kale with Primary Health Partners in Edmond, say they've seen patients with similar complaints as Paula.
I had one patient who lost a lot of hair because of it, and we couldn't figure out what was going on until she had the implants removed, and then it was reversed.
Dr. Kale has also seen patients suffering from headaches or neurological symptoms, although she can't definitively say those were caused by implants.
8 years ago, the FDA identified a possible link between implants and a form of lymphoma, but so far, no scientific connections have been made to all of these other illnesses and symptoms. There is a push for more research, though.
Our NBC affiliate, KXAS in Dallas, spoke to Dr. William Adams. He's on a newly formed breast implant illness task force with the American Society of Plastic Surgeons.
It is something that's of interest to us as the doctors of these patients and being an advocate of our patients.
Meanwhile, women like Paula are demanding answers.
Their scientific proof is that there are thousands of women that are sick every day. There is no answer except for they all have that one thing in common. They have implants or had implants.
And hoping others will hear their warning before getting implants. Lauren Daniels, Oklahoma's News 4.